Hi, and welcome to the first podcast from Chronicles of Yarnia from the team at Yarnia, our Montclair's local yarn store. I'm Jen.
Amanda.
Kathleen. And we're happy to talk to you today. If you haven't met us yet, we are a yarn store in Montclair, New Jersey, as Jen said, that has been open for about 18 months. Yep. We've loved meeting all sorts of new people in that time. We've had great reception in the community, and we're just excited to expand our community with our podcast.
Yep, and so we'll be talking about some things that are on our needles, some projects we just finished, and new yarns that are in the store, new events coming up. It'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah, and if you guys have any questions, if you want to ask us anything, come on into the store, drop a comment in the comments below, or you can follow us online. We are Shop Yarnia on Instagram, on Snapchat, on Facebook. We're Yarnia. And you can also sign up for our mailing list on our website. Just go to shopyarnia.com and check in the About Us section. And we send out a newsletter about once a week. And we have classes, events, new yarns that come in, basically anything that we can think of on Sunday night when I write it.
We're on Ravelry 2 is Shop Yarnia.
Thank you. I forgot Ravelry. Yep.
And if you like our podcast and want to find out when we have episode number 2, click the bell in the bottom in the thing below. Click like the podcast.
Yeah, all the Dwilly Bob stuff down below. Expand it down. Follow us. You love us.
And there'll be show notes below that has all the projects that we talk about and the yarns that we talk about, as well as all the information on where you can find us online.
Yeah,
that's right. So shall we start talking about some whips?
Yeah, sure. You're working now, so why don't you tell us what you got?
I am working now, actually. I am working on my second bobble hat. It's a pattern that was from the Shetland Wool Walk from a few years ago. I had always admired it. I did one in, December maybe, or January. I think actually this is my first finished object of the year.
I think it was.
And this is done with all yarns from the shop, Swan's Island, for the grass and the sky, which is available online at shopyarnia.com. Yep. And then Juniper Moon 14 for the sheep, because I wanted my sheep to be nice and fluffy and fuzzy.
They're so fuzzy.
And then Sugar Ridge Bold for the faces and the feet, which I loved. It was a little bit of a mix of weights, but I think it works well.
Wow, those they're like very different textured yarns, but they look so nice.
It's really fun.
That's
cool. Yep. So the first one was traditional green grass and blue sky, and I decided to mix it up and do bluegrass and green sky.
Bluegrass, green sky.
Bluegrass. I never even thought
it was totally bluegrass.
So it's bluegrass. So that's kind of fun. So
cool.
So why don't we see what somebody else is working on?
All right, I am working on my second mitt of the Fightin' Word mitts. I have BAM.
Oh, who's that pattern?
Done. I cannot remember, but check out the notes below and we'll tell you.
I'll put it down.
We'll link to it in Ravelry, but it's Fightin' Words. And so this one says BAM. I don't know if you can see, but we'll see if we can show you. And the one that I'm working on now says, will say POW. I'm currently in the midst of the color work and I've just started increasing for the thumb. This is done in Oink Pigments. They came for a trunk show a couple months ago. And their yarns are super cute, super great company. We love them. And they had great little minis of fingering weight, two of which were perfect for this mitt pattern. And, of course, as a comic book fan, I couldn't resist.
Yeah, those trunk shows are fun.
I love trunk shows.
It lets us bring in a lot of, indie designers, indie dyers that can't, we have 400 square feet. We don't have room to stock everybody.
Yes. Everything that we love.
Yeah, but bringing them in.
And also you get to meet the dyer, and that's so great to see the person who has actually laid hands on the yarn and come up with the whole kind of colorway concept and talk to them, and they always have such great suggestions for what
they really
to do.
Know what their yarns are good for.
This, yeah, I absolutely. Don't think I would have thought, I don't think I would have found the pattern necessarily, because every time I go into Ravelry, I end up looking for something and finding things that I don't mean to find, but still love. But I don't think I would have necessarily found the Fightin' Words mitts pattern unless she had the sample there.
Right,
and
Helena
then she was
had
like,
the sample, she had, suggestions for how to put it together to do them.
Suggestions, and she helped both me and a couple of other customers help pick out colorways, which is so great when you have somebody who knows not just what kinds of yarns they have, but what it works really well for.
Right.
And what projects to do. And I absolutely love these. And hopefully they won't get stolen by my kids who have already been like, I'm going to use these as video game knits. And I was like, those are mommy's. Back off. So apparently I have to make them some.
Yeah.
I think they would like them too.
Bam and
Trump. Sure they will. Yep.
Yeah. And we have another Trump show coming up.
Yes.
Here at Yarnia. The 30th, right?
Of the March? 30th. Yes. And it's Rhythm Knits.
The very end of March.
Rhythm Knits.
Which, if you haven't seen her yarns, go check them out online. They are stunning. I cannot wait for this. I have, like...
I honestly hadn't, like, looked at her stuff very much. Shame on me. But you posted that picture in the newsletter this week, and oh my goodness.
To die. Yeah. And it was also, like, the perfect colorway for Amanda with, like, the blues and the purples.
The lavenders,
like,
in there.
So pretty. So yeah, we're definitely super psyched for her to come. I think it'll be great. I think it'll be really great. And also, again, like, if you want to know, we're scheduling new events all the time. So, like, just keep in touch with us, and then we'll keep in touch with you guys and let you know what's going on.
Yeah.
And what are you working on, Amanda? Didn't you finish?
Speaking of purple. I'll show you my whip, since y'all are talking about whips first.
Yeah.
We're having a clean out your queue knit along. So all those sweaters that you had in your queue and you wish you'd started but never had quite the motivation, we all started together at the end of January, beginning of February. So I had two sweaters I started. This is one of them. This is the Zweig sweater.
So pretty.
Yeah, by Boylan Knitworks, Caitlin Hunter, right? So it's a fingering weight, and I'm knitting this in Ancient Arts yarn, their sock NATO base. Honestly, I was in here for knit night on a Wednesday and saw them sitting back there on the wall, sort of like next to each other. And I was like, that would be the perfect
combo. Yeah.
So I finished all the yoke. And I'm down in the body, and I am doing the textures on the body.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of people talk about whether to do it or not. I think it does add something.
Yeah.
It really does.
I think it's going to add an extra month to the time it's going to take me to do this sweater.
That too. True. But it'll be worth it because you'll have it for a long, long time.
Right.
So,
yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. What am I knitting these on? I'm knitting these on size 5 needles. So it's going pretty fast, and I'm going to be doing some business travel, and this is going to be the only project that goes with me. So hopefully I'll get
knowing
good
you,
place.
It'll be done by the, at least the body will be done when you're back.
Only tell them how long it took to do the sweater you're wearing.
Yeah. So
that's right. Let's go on to finished objects.
So this is my newest finished sweater. I finished it actually this morning. But I started it a week ago Sunday.
So pretty.
What pattern?
This is the Saturday night sweater.
Oh, and that's what you're calling it, your Sunday sweater. Yeah.
We kept getting it confused. There's a Saturday night sweater and there's a Sunday night sweater.
Yeah.
And they're both by
Petite Knits.
Petite Knits.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And so this is, here, I'll sort of stand up.
Yeah. Cute.
So pretty.
It literally took me, I could have easily finished it in a week if I didn't have a lot of kids. So which take a lot of time, but it's really a fun pattern. It's
what yarn did you use?
Knit and Drizzle, which is silk mohair.
Mm-hmm.
But you hold 4 strands together, so it's actually a bulky pattern.
It's a bulky.
It's knit on a 10.75 needle, which is a 7mm. That's one of those funky European sizes
that we have even numbers
in millimeters. But
the metric English conversion never really quite crossed over.
Yeah, and I like this one a lot. It has nice short rows in the back.
It fits beautifully.
Very nice.
Yeah, and like the way that the sleeves are done, it's just like straight to here. And then she has a really cool way of making sure that they, you know, come in on the side, so it's like cute.
Yeah,
it's a cute little puff sweater.
Yeah.
Very nice.
I always like it when I have a sweater that, you know, if I went shopping, I think I'd buy it.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's the end goal, I think, a lot of it is to not necessarily mimic machine knit or machine wearing things, but to have something that you made yourself that is totally 100% your style.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And that's straight up what you have there.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
And like you said, it's nice when you're like, you know, if I'd seen this in a store, I would have bought it. This is so me that, you know, but it's even better because you're able to completely customize it to yourself.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
And so people will be like, where'd you get it? And you'll be like, I made it. Kathleen, why don't you go for a finished object?
All right, I will go for a finished object. So, I did a colorwork class in the store in January, actually.
You taught the class.
Yeah, I taught the class. And, not took the class. but we love our classes here. I mean, the students, we just have a lot of fun. I mean, it's kind of awesome. Yeah, and especially some of them, well, whatever, we'll get into that another time. I was going to say they're more like parties, but those are more the evening classes a lot of the time.
Yeah, the hanging out.
So I was teaching a colorwork hat class, and I thought I could find a pattern that I liked on Ravelry and would just use that, and I never really did find anything that was exactly what I wanted, so played around with some standard motifs and came up with what I'm calling the Nordic Star hat, and just published it on Ravelry last night.
Woohoo!
But everyone in the class did a test knit for me, basically, they were all successful.
Oh, that's such a good idea.
So since I just finally published it last night, I'm going to gift it to all of them today.
Oh,
it was definitely past my bedtime by the time I hit publish.
What is your pattern store on Ravelry called?
It is under Vandy.
Check it out on Vandy under Ravelry, and you can also get a Norwegian Star hat. I mean, I love that colorway that you did, and I saw the other ones that you did also were so, like, gorgeous and classic, but, like, I think that one is my favorite.
This one is interesting, and I said this in the pattern notes. I actually think, even though it is such a traditional pattern, the colors that you use can make it feel kind of modern.
Yeah,
totally.
And if you look at my finished projects on Ravelry, so many of them are, you know, it started with my Grello Comfort Fade Cardi.
Yeah.
But I've been so into the gray and yellow for a good year now. So this was done in Germantown, which we carry in the store.
I love Germantown.
And with three skeins.
We have a
skeins,
complete line. Like, the
exactly,
whole line
we
of
do. We got
Germantown.
All the colors, yeah. So with three skeins of Germantown, you can make three complete hats.
Wow.
Which is pretty darn cool.
That's
amazing.
That's a good thing to keep in mind for holiday
for gift-getting.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Starting in, like, August.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Cranking out some colorwork hats
late.
And some Germantown. No, I start real late. Sometimes it's, like, December, and I'm like, who's getting something on the needle?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, I love that hat.
Anyway, so that is the Nordic Star hat, and, you know.
Cool. So what did you do different in this pattern that you couldn't find?
There was nothing that was exactly what I wanted. I mean, there were some that had different motifs at the bottom, and there were some that were free patterns. And, you know, I like to support designers on Ravelry when somebody puts the work in and does something and has a test knit and, you know, really goes through all those steps. You know, sometimes free patterns are good, but sometimes you get what you pay for.
Yeah.
And so a lot of the things that I was finding were free and, you know, were basically someone did something and wrote up their notes and put it out there, which is, you know, which can be helpful, but, you know, because it was for a class, I really went through and made sure they were going to have a good learning experience. And so the other thing, actually, that I think is a bit unique about the pattern is I did three different versions of the chart in it.
Yeah.
So on the page with the directions, there is a standard, you know, white background and two different colors of contrast for the bands and the stars. But there's an additional page that's kind of like a coloring page. So, and that was actually what inspired my colors for this, because I was trying to find something that would be two pale shades that you'd be able to color over. So you wanted to do, you know, blue and pink or whatever you wanted to do. And then the third version is with a dark background, which that was something that we talked about in the class. You know, if you've got a chart where the background is light, but the color that you're working with as your main color is dark, for every stitch, you need to switch in your head what is light and what is dark.
And it's so hard to do that.
You know, it can be difficult. I mean, everyone has different learning styles, and that can be really...
Yeah.
It can put some people off color work, honestly, at the end of the day. So by putting in the three different versions of the chart, I think it's going to really be a useful pattern for people.
Oh, cool.
I think so, too. Yeah. And I did something similar in a color work sweater class that we are almost done with, and actually That will segue nicely into my almost finished object, which is...
Very close.
Let me show it.
AFO.
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 AFO. So this is Tin Can Knits Dog Star Sweater, knit in, again, Kelborn Woolens, this time Scout, their DK weight. And we did a colorwork class for doing a colorwork sweater. And I love the Tin Can Knits patterns because they have every size, and every size from infant through, I think it's 4 or 5
adults.
XL,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which is so fantastic, especially for a class when not everybody is the same size and not everybody wants to knit an adult sweater. Mm-hmm. Although, interestingly, only one person knit a kid's sweater, so I was like, all right, that's cool. Mm-hmm. But for picking the color work colors, we had basically the whole palette of Scout to choose from, plus any other DK weight that the students wanted to use. But like the hardest part, I feel like, of color work is making the decision on what colors to throw in, and I'm the worst. So I was like, all right, we're gonna swatch, we're gonna do this, and then like Kathleen, I essentially took the charts in Dogstar and made a coloring page in Excel. Or Google Sheets, where very pale gray against white, printed it out and said, all right, let's go color things in. Because I couldn't make a decision, so I'm sitting there for like 2 hours with markers.
Oh, man.
And my kids again are like, why are you taking my markers? And I'm like, Mommy's working. Back off. But it was such a good way to figure it out. And then also, when it came time, because this is a bottom-up sweater, when it came time to do the color work, I could not remember what I had decided. But I had my coloring page.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I could reference that and see. And it just, it helped so much in terms of placing the colors and figuring out what to do where and change the background, do this. But anyway, I am at the neck. I'm at the bind-off.
Oh,
I tried it on.
At Knitting Circle
this morning to make sure that it wasn't too tight, because I'm...
And it looked great.
It was
a nice fit. Not too tight a neck.
I think I'm pretty good. I'm fundamentally incapable of knitting a pattern as written. I always adjust it. So I made 3/4 sleeves.
Ditto.
And I'm like, do I mess with the neck? And da 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 da. But I think it's good to go.
Oh, and is that as it was written?
The neck is as written.
Interesting.
I did modify the sleeves. I made
them
a little bit shorter and a little bit tighter per my preference.
Mm-hmm.
And then did some math and it all worked out fine.
That's good to know though about the neck of that, because like we were talking about at Circle.
Yeah.
I feel like it's the modern crew neck. It's not super high. It's not right up to your collarbones. It's a little bit lower. It's a little bit more easy to wear.
Yeah.
So.
And I stopped the ribbing basically right when they said to, I think it's like an inch and a half or something like that. And I'm at an inch of ribbing. So I'm ready to do a tubular bind off. And if I were making this for like my husband, who likes a tighter crew neck, I would probably
just do another
couple of rows of ribbing and it would go
clip
right in and be great.
Mm-hmm.
So I think our next class will show them the finishing, and I left in.
Yeah. I was about to say, you left your waist yarn in here.
I always do this. And I did this especially for the class. When you're doing a bottom up sweater, you know how you throw your sleeves or your body on waist yarn.
Right. Yeah.
I leave it in partially. So if, when I join the body and the sleeves together, if I screw up or if I need to rip back or if I'm like, I need to change something, I don't have to sit there and be super paranoid about picking up my stitches. So I also...
To get it back on the
needle. This way I can just rip with it, like yank the needle out, rip, and not have that panic attack that I'm going to lose
an inch too far
of sleeves.
That's never happened before.
Never. And I also, on one side, partially because I was showing the class how to do a lifeline, I put a lifeline in, I don't know if y'all can see, I put a lifeline
I'll
in right there. Yeah.
Post it.
Amanda will show it in and throw in her technological magic. For the same reason, whereas like, if I need to yank out the yoke for whatever reason, I can. It's also really handy if you need to measure from a certain point.
Yes.
So like,
definitely.
When you join, sometimes this Tin Can Knits had the number of rows you needed to knit in stockinette, which was great because then you didn't need to think about like measuring.
So if your gauge is right, you know how many rows.
Yeah, if your gauge is right or close to right.
Close.
We'll say close to right.
Give you close a ballpark anyway.
But if it says knit an inch plain, then you don't have to sit there and figure out, like, is this row
where
my underarm is?
Yeah.
Or is this row where my underarm is? You have a clearly delineated line to measure from.
That's smart.
I do it for top-down sweaters, too, when you abandon the sleeves. Because I seem to always futz with sleeves. And whatever. It's my thing. But that way, if you abandon your sleeves and when you pick up your stitches to work them down from the top down, if you leave in your waist yarn, then you have a good measuring point. So you can measure exactly like, okay, my sleeve needs to be 15 inches. I have a nice line to measure from, and you can kind of do it on the fly. You don't actually have to sit there put it on the table. You can do it on the couch while you're watching TV.
I'm always measuring from a stitch marker.
I don't throw in my stitch markers like that.
Yeah.
But I know you do.
I do. I have got dangly things under my arm from knitting sweaters.
I feel like whatever works for you. Know what you know.
I like this, though.
I like it. And then people are like, that's an interesting design element. I'm like, no. I'm going to pull it out.
People always think it's a design element when they see this.
And you might see when you do pull it out, sometimes you get like a little bit of looseness going on. But once you block it, it's fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like it all goes away. It's all good.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So that's my what? No.
I can't wait
to see
my
whip. It's not my finished offo. Object. My offo. Here's my offo.
All right.
But I have to say, I love this scout yarn.
Yeah. Oh, I do too. It. Actually, can I? You want? Shall I do one little more peek at a at a whip?
Sure.
Because I did not. I almost audited Jen's colorwork sweater class because I was dying to make another colorwork sweater, but it didn't work out time wise. And then I found a beautiful pattern from Espace Tricot
with
their podcast. So this is the Stone and Poncho, also done in Scout.
I love it.
And as Jen, I can rarely do anything exactly as written. Well, you know, we're making it, so that should be part of it. You should be...
That's the whole point of making
it
yourself.
And that's one of the things that we love to give students, the freedom to know, like, when you can modify things and how to modify things without, you know, without sort of terror that you're going too far.
When to go off track and when to stay on track.
Yeah, exactly. So one of the things I did with this was I shortened the neckline a little bit.
Cute.
Because it's a turtleneck.
Oh, right. Okay.
And I made it a little, it's not quite going to be a mock turtleneck, but it's not going to fold as much.
Like almost like a stand-up?
Yeah, exactly. And I haven't even finished this yet, and I feel like I am going to make another one, because I love it so much.
So
it's a beautiful pattern.
That navy.
Yeah. And
then I'll put a picture in.
The navy and the white are Scout, which, as Jen said, is just lovely to work with. And actually, as of next Monday, well, by the time the podcast is out, we will have the full line of Scout in the store.
It's so pretty,
we
you guys.
We special ordered it for Jen's class, but we loved it. She loved it so much. Everyone loved it. So we got the whole line in.
I might have this podcast out by Friday.
Okay. All right.
It'll be a race to see which gets out first.
We'll link to it if we have it out.
Yeah.
And the... what I did for the third color, I used some of our Knitted Wit gumballs. Yeah, so the lavender.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, I love lavender, and I tried to pick up some of the highlights of
goodness.
The navy heather.
Yeah.
So I used, this is
also
a gumball. Isn't that? Yeah, so pretty. I used gumballs for these too, because as much as I love the purple, there wasn't enough contrast with the navy.
Right. Yeah.
So
yeah.
Where the third color was on the main color, I swapped it out for yet another color. So it's
perfect.
Been so much
it's
fun.
So
I'm
pretty.
Loving making this.
Minis are so good for that kind of thing where you just need like a little pop of like yellow or hot pink or whatever. And you can just throw it right in.
Yep.
So that is that.
Yeah. And whereas you might not knit a whole sweater out of pink.
Right. That little pink. Accent. Is
yeah.
Fun. It definitely.
It's perfect.
One of the things I was talking to the Colorwork Sweater students about when we were picking colors, and it's actually how I picked my colorway for this. It was like, pick a couple of colors that you like and then throw in one that you don't. Or one that you wouldn't, not that you don't necessarily
that you wouldn't
like
necessarily
it, but the
wear.
One that you wouldn't pick. So I was
like,
okay, let's throw in a yellow because I don't wear yellow that often, but it looks great in color work. And let's throw in like a coral pink in this mix of two colors that I default to all the time. Teal and green.
Mm-hmm.
And it worked beautifully. It just kind of livened it all up rather than
definitely.
Just go straight for white, which was what I was looking at. But I think that helps. It's so hard to do the color choices sometimes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It really is.
Yeah. All right. So shall we chat a little bit about Wool Walk?
Yes.
All right.
So let's talk about Wool Walk.
Wait.
Well, I'll just show you this and I'll put a bigger picture. We have these in the store. This is the brochure for the 2019 Wool Walk, which is
New Jersey Wool Walk.
New Jersey. Yeah. Wool Walk. And it is
April 4th?
April 4th through 7th.
So it's a Thursday through Sunday.
Yes. Thursday to Sunday. And there, how many shops are in there?
18 this year.
18 this year, yeah.
Last year was 15. We have 3 new shops.
We're
one of the
us.
New shops.
Yay, new shop.
Also, the yarn shop at Alma Park in Jobstown and the local yarn store in South Orange.
Yeah.
Three
are
new
the
shops.
Other new shops, yeah. Yeah.
Which it's
and
good
so I guess everyone who participated last year is doing it again, which
yeah.
is great.
Which is awesome.
It's wonderful to have a healthy yarn store community in our state.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Really, and such a supportive yarn store community. Like, it's
absolutely.
Also really great that New Jersey is a small enough state that you can actually hit all 18.
Yeah,
you can.
You can.
Some
you got to commit.
Some of our Knit Night folks did it last year. Yeah.
Yeah.
They, you know, got to all
which
of
is
the
great.
Stores, which
and
is fabulous.
And you can get the Wool Walk Passport with your local yarn store in New Jersey. We have them here at Yarnia. And you'll get a stamp at every store.
Yeah, so you
every
take the passport. The passport's
yeah.
$6,
yep.
right?
Mm-hmm.
$1 yeah. of that is donated to Autism Speaks.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. Take that passport with you all weekend to all the yarn stores you go to. At each yarn store, you don't have to buy anything, but take it to the register, and they'll
but
stamp
you
it. Well, mm-hmm. Of course.
You can't resist it.
And actually, one of the nice things during the Wool Walk is that every store has a good selection of merchandise on sale. As
yeah,
well
we're
going to
have some really cool deals,
featuring
guys.
Whatever
and
specialties
raffles.
Are. Yeah. Yep.
Raffles.
Yep.
And we have, like, some awesome things planned, including, should we talk about the pouches?
Sure.
These
yes.
super cute Notions pouches, which Amanda will probably show a better picture of than me just randomly holding it up. And it has our logo on it. It's a little canvas pouch that's perfect for, like, crochet hooks or double points or Notions, whatever. And how do they get this?
They get it. The first 100 customers to spend $100 or more will get one complimentary
yeah.
From us to commemorate the Wool Walk.
Yay!
Yep.
So
yeah.
get here early.
Yeah.
Because I feel like these are going to go really quick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so.
Exactly.
But the nice thing is, on that Friday night, April 5th,
mm-hmm.
we're going to have a late night kind of like yarn party.
Yarn party.
Exactly. Maybe that's what we'll call it, because we haven't
yes.
really figured out like what kind of name, but there'll be like yarn and good times and maybe some bubbly things.
And some of the other things that we're going to have during the Wool Walk that are special to it are... in the past, the New Jersey Walk has had bags, tote bags available.
Yes.
They've been doing that for a few years, and the group felt like it was time for a change. So they're doing enamel pins this year. So
love
there
it.
Will be a 2019 Wool Walk pin, and most of the stores, including Yarnia, will be doing our own enamel pin as well.
Yay.
So, and those will be $6 each as well. So you can get all the
bring
swag.
Your bag.
You can get all the swag, all the Wool Walk swag for under $20, which is kind of cool. If you,
that is
you,
cool.
You get your passport,
yes.
you get your Yarnia pin, you get your Wool Walk pin.
At the end of the weekend, you can have, like, all of these amazing pins on your bag, and then you can be all like, Jersey!
Yeah. And at the end of the weekend, last store you go to, don't forget to leave your
yes,
passport.
Turn
yes.
in your passport.
Because
for
that's
sure.
how you get entered
mm-hmm.
into the grand prize.
And
draw.
You could all, you know, there'll be a little bit of lag time too. If anybody forgets, I'm sure, you
yeah.
know, well, you can
yeah.
drop it off at your
take
yarn store
your
and
yarn
they'll
store.
Get it onto the central point. And then it is early May that the drawing will be for,
yeah.
There are going to be 3 prizes that all of the stores
that's what I was
going to
ask. What are the prizes? Do we know?
The prizes will be determined on our call either this week or next week.
Cool.
TBD.
But there we
They're always nice.
Yeah.
They're significant, you know. They're nice prizes. The people who win them are always really happy.
Yeah.
So, oh yeah. So
prizes.
So Wool Walk prizes.
Yes.
Actually, one of the things that's been really fun as a new store owner is to participate in these monthly conference calls with all the other yarn stores and hear what they've done before and everything. So we do have another call either this Thursday or next Thursday to finalize what the prizes are.
Cool.
But in the past, they've done things like a massage gift certificate.
Ooh.
You know, things that anyone would be happy to use, basically.
Oh, yes, I would be happy
so,
to use that.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Especially after going to all 18 stores.
Yeah.
You're
yeah,
really going to
totally.
Want that massage.
Absolutely. And actually... You know, and there are prizes for multiple levels. Like, I think there's a prize for, you know, if you turn in a passport, you visited at least one store, you're eligible for
oh,
one
that's
prize.
Cool.
That's so great.
And then, you know, like, maybe if you visited half of them, you're eligible for a second level prize.
Oh, yeah.
And for the real diehards who are out there, you know, driving on the turnpike in the Garden
yeah.
State all through that Thursday
we
through
see
Sunday.
You.
Yes.
We like
they,
you.
they qualify for the biggest prize.
Well, that's just a lot of
so,
fun. I
yeah,
know we went out.
Is.
before we opened the store.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
It was a lot of fun.
Oh my god, it was so much fun.
And remember, Chanel was with us.
Yep.
Chanel.
Hey, Pepper, we miss you, Chanel. So, the Wool Walk is really a great time. And it's you know, just good to support all the yarn stores in New Jersey and see what everyone has that's unique, because everyone does have some unique things.
You might be introduced to, you know, a store that you don't know, or a yarn that you don't know, or a design you don't know.
Yeah.
Which I always love.
Yeah.
I like learning new things.
Yeah, absolutely.
Speaking of new things, so we have a couple of new yarns in store that we want to show you that we are in love with.
Mm-hmm.
One of the nice things about being a small store is that we don't have the space to carry things that we don't love.
That's right. That is for sure.
So you'll hear us say like, oh my God, we love this, and this is so awesome, because everything that we carry in the store, we have to love.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We just don't
have enough space to be storing things and, you know, holding on to things that we don't love.
So. But and that's the great thing is that, you know, we love them, you know, so we hope that you guys love them. And
mm-hmm. And so far, we've been doing pretty well with that.
I think so.
Our customers seem to be pretty happy with our choices.
Let us know if we're not.
Let
us know that we are. Please. Positive feedback. So I have
all feedback is good.
All feedback is good.
It is good.
But, really,
but we especially love... We're normal people. We love positive feedback.
Poor Amanda is caught between the two. So I have a bucket here of... or basket here of Astral, which, Amanda, do you want to... Talk a little bit about.
Well, Astral is from the Alpaca Yarn Company. We had a couple of yarns from the Alpaca Yarn Company last summer that we brought in, but this one, when our yarn rep came this year, I saw it and I'm like, we have to have it.
It's so pretty.
It's incredibly beautiful.
I want to wrap myself in it.
Yeah, so it's 30% alpaca, 20% wool, and 50% tinsel. And that tinsel just makes it drape, right? Like,
mm-hmm.
It's very
drapey. It's super drapey.
And secondly, it has this, like, sheen. It glows from the inside.
It does.
Like
it really does. Yeah.
A shiny, hazy, it's like single ply. I cannot get enough of
but
this
color. But
it's
like an elegant shiny. It's not like a glitzy shiny.
No,
it's
very,
yeah. It's really.
What is it? Color 8641. Very descriptive code name. But I freaking love it. It's like this gray, greeny, teal. Yeah. Shocker. But it's so beautiful. What weight is this?
These are DK.
DK.
Yep.
Oh, that would be such a pretty, like, wrap or...
A wrap would be perfect. Yeah.
Poncho in this.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. So we have a bunch of colors.
We do.
At least a dozen.
At least a dozen colors. We got a bunch of blues and grays.
Oh, I think I got the reds.
I love the reds. And this kind of goldy green.
That is my
color. I'm going to give it to Kathleen because this is Kathleen's color.
I've been wearing this since I was about 16 years old. This is my color.
It's so like, it's like
bronzy green.
Yeah, that bronzy green. And here's a purple for Amanda.
This is
Amanda likes purple.
I'm like really feeling this color. I don't. This is like the 2019
it's
color
of
that
the
live
color
coral.
Of the year.
It's
yeah.
like that coral that I did.
That's right.
I have as an accent in my color sweater.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
I love it. It's such a beautiful color range.
Really see these with like some of those mosaic knitting shawls that are out.
Pretty would that be?
Mm-hmm.
Those
How
together.
Pretty would that be? I wonder if you could do your sweater in this, because I can't do mohair. As pretty as it is, I love it. It hates me, unfortunately. But, like, this has the haze and the sheen and a drape.
Yeah,
I wonder, like,
that would be
messing
nice.
With the gauge, that would be so, or, like, two together.
You'd have to know what you're doing, though.
Yeah, you'd have to really know. That's not a...
I think you almost could even substitute it as is. I really
do.
Because
the fuzz will kind of fill in.
Yeah, exactly.
It'd be a little bit more sheer.
Mm-hmm. That's, like... My kids do science projects in my kitchen. That's like a science project on your needle.
Yeah,
to see
it
totally works.
Is.
That's right.
Again,
that's right.
I'm constitutionally incapable of not messing with things.
But these are fantastic.
I
can't wait
them.
To get a sample in the shop with these.
Yeah,
yes,
definitely.
Yeah.
And it's been moving well even without a sample, which is nice. People have seen how gorgeous it is.
Because you see it on the shelf
like
and you're like, look at
that. Ooh, what's that?
I want to touch it.
What's that?
It's incredible.
Mm-hmm. I love it. I love it. So gorgeous.
Yay.
Thank you.
Cool. So our other new yarn that we brought in fairly recently is Rowan Felted Tweed.
It's not only but a goodie.
Absolutely.
In the knitting
Classic.
World.
Yep. And this is a DK, as many Rowan yarns are. So another thing it would mix well with is Scout, actually.
Yeah.
As Jen and I were talking about, that could be really fun to do, you know, something with two main mixing colors and then throw in one of these as an accent.
Because the felted tweed is really great for color work, right? I know it is. The Rowan pattern support has a lot of color work going on in there.
Yep. And our colleague Beth, who who, you know, is in the store every other weekend working here with us, loves Rowan for color work, has done things so in this in
well,
the
I just
past,
watched
so.
A interview of Martin Story on the Fruity Knitting podcast, and he has a couple of full books of color work and felted tweed that are just incredible.
Yep. I'm sorry, I need to see the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's super pretty.
This, I think we have 16 or 17 colors. I kind of feel like we randomly have 17 colors. I don't know why, but
I think we do have
17
colors.
I think we do because we were trying to pick 15 and then we had too many
good
colors.
So we
could
limit it out.
So pretty.
So, yeah. So we have many colors of this. And,
I love it. I love it. What's the fabric makeup? It is a felted effect yarn made with merino wool and alpaca. So it'll be, it's got
50%
like this
wool, 25% alpaca, and 25% viscose.
Oh, that's great. So it's nice. It's slightly felted, so it's going to be both hard wearing, but also kind of really pop in your color work. And they're all these gorgeous tweedy colors. Like this green has a lot of like little blue and a little bit of gray.
Yeah.
And I love tweed.
And it's
tweed
nice.
And heather.
It's nice yardage too. It's 191 yards and 50 grams.
That's
so
great.
that is really good yardage.
And I love these 50 gram balls for color work
because
then
you don't
get
have to buy
100 grams
for something you only need a little bit.
Then you don't have 400 yards left from 450 yard skein that you've used. Not that you can't figure out something else to do with it, like Kathleen's bobble hat.
Yep.
Like color reversing.
Yeah.
Make it again. Make it again.
Yeah, make it again. Mix it
we
up.
We all love that.
Mix
we
it
all
up.
Love that.
So.
Let's see what else we got.
Okay. Well, yeah, actually, I have to
head to the airport.
Amanda's running off to the airport.
As she does.
Because she has more time in the day than anyone else I know.
I
don't know how that happens.
She has a time turner,
she's amazing.
We are convinced.
Oh my God, you are Hermione.
I wish.
She secretly is.
I spend it three times, though, so I get one day of sleep.
My God, I would totally do that. It never occurred to me to do that, but I would totally do that.
Yes.
Totally do that.
Oh my goodness.
I wish we didn't have to sleep.
I like sleep.
I don't care about sleep. I wish I could knit all night instead of sleeping.
I wish I could knit all day and then sleep.
And I think I'm still not recovered from daylight savings time.
Nobody.
Yeah.
Said
there is that. There is
daylight
that.
Savings time.
That's why I was
Mercury retrograde.
We're all screwed, basically.
But anyway, thank you guys for joining us for our very first podcast.
Yay.
And remember, follow us on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook,
Ravelry.
Website, Ravelry, and
subscribe.
And our subscribe to our channel. So all of the information is in the little dweedly bob down below. So check it out then, and we'll see you a couple
soon.
Weeks.
We'll
soon?
See you soon.
Soon.
So goodbye from Kathleen,
Amanda,
Jen,
at Yarnia.
Bye.
Bye.